This video is a brief introduction to cells. Cells are the fundamental units of life. That's right, all organisms are made of cells. A cell is defined as the simplest collection of matter that can live, you know, consume energy, grow, reproduce, adapt to its environment, etc. Some organisms are only made up of a single cell, like this cyanobacteria in green in the top left, or this amoeba over to the right, or these strange-looking protists in the bottom left. Other organisms are made up of more cells, like this adorable hamster, and this stunning sea slug. Now, all cells are really quite small. You have about 10 trillion cells that make up your body right now. The study of cells requires microscopes, because they're simply too small to be seen well with the naked eye. The first microscopes were used in the 1600s, but major advancements have occurred since then, with specific improvements in the last 100 years. Here you see three pictures of the exact same organism, a paramecium, with three different types of microscopes. The images produced are called micrographs. This kind of table on the right gives you an idea of just how small cells are. Cells are seen here in the middle. And this chart also shows you what you can see with various kinds of microscopes. You don't need a microscope to see a human being or even a chicken's egg, but individual cells would require at least the use of a light microscope. This is the kind of microscope that we use in class, and it's just barely powerful enough to see some common bacteria that you might find, say, on your skin. However, to visualize the smallest bacteria, viruses, or biomolecules, you'd need something much, much more powerful. And again, in the last 100 years, we've made that technology. You need something like an electron microscope, which are actually pretty big, amazing, powerful microscopes. While there are many kinds of cells and organisms, from bacteria to brain cells to sperm, all cells can be broken into two main kinds of cells. There are more simple prokaryotic cells, which lack any kind of membrane-enclosed structures inside them. And then there are these eukaryotic cells, which possess many kinds of membrane-enclosed substructures, and we call those substructures organelles. Some examples of prokaryotes include bacteria and archaea, and some examples of eukaryotic cells are the cells that make up protozoa, fungi, animals, plants, you, your nephew. We'll come back to some differences in these cell types momentarily, but for now, let's discuss what's common between these two cell types. All cells have these basic features: a plasma membrane, which surrounds the cell, the cytoplasm, which is what's inside the cell, chromosomal DNA, and ribosomes, which are structures that make proteins. So we'll examine each of these elements briefly. So let's start with the plasma membrane. All cells are surrounded by a plasma membrane, and that regulates what enters and exits the cell. This is like a security checkpoint of sorts. It controls what goes in and what goes out. So let's talk about what's inside that cell. What's inside is called the cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is mostly made up of something called cytosol, which you can think of as having the consistency of a runny gel. It's kind of like a hair product or hand sanitizer, that kind of consistency. So cytosol's gel-like substance is filled with water, fibers, skeletal elements, and lots of molecules. In eukaryotic cells, the cytoplasm doesn't just include the cytosol, it also includes those membrane-bound organelles we mentioned, but all cells have this cytosol filling. Third, all cells have DNA in them, and that DNA gets packaged very, very tightly and densely into structures we call chromosomes. And so that's why I've been calling it chromosomal DNA. And that chromosomal DNA is located a little bit differently depending on the cell type. And you can see that in the eukaryotic cell, that DNA is surrounded by a nucleus. But in the prokaryotic cell, it's not. In the prokaryotic cell, it's just kind of free. It does actually cluster, and so we call that kind of cluster where the DNA is, the nucleoid. But you should definitely keep in mind that the nucleoid doesn't have a membrane around it. Only eukaryotic cells have a membrane-bound structure that encloses that DNA. So very finally, the ribosomes. And these are tiny organelles that assemble amino acids into proteins. And where those ribosomes are located depends on the type of cell. So here you see some ribosomes kind of being speckled throughout these two different kinds of cells. And you can see that both the cells, the eukaryotic cell on the left and the prokaryotic cell on the right, both have a bunch of ribosomes in that cytoplasm. In the eukaryotic cell, you can also see that some ribosomes are bound to some particular organelle, one of those membrane-bound structures called the endoplasmic reticulum. Only eukaryotic cells have ribosomes bound to some of these membrane-bound organelles. So that's basically the lesson that I have for you today on cells. But wait, let's do a quick review before you go to make sure you understand some of the core concepts. So which of the following organisms pictured below is not made up of cells? A, an albino snake, kind of creepy looking. B, the most adorable bunny I could find on the internet. C, a blue-ringed octopus. Or D, these pretty succulent desert plants. Are any of these made up of something other than cells? This is a trick question. The answer is no. All of these organisms are made up of cells. Every organism is made up of cells, from the tiniest little bacteria all the way up to a whale. Every single organism is made up of cells. So this was a little bit of a trick question. I hope I didn't flub you up too much. That bunny really is cute, isn't it? It's so cute. Okay, next question. Which of the following is not a feature found in every cell? Think about it. Can you think of what the right answer is? Well, I hope you came up with it. The answer is C, nucleus. All cells have DNA, but not all cells have a nucleus. Only eukaryotic cells have a nucleus, which remember is a membrane-bound enclosure around that DNA. Last question. One of the major differences between prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells is question mark. Another tricky one. Think you know what it is? Okay, here we go. Here comes the answer. Pause it if you don't want to see the answer yet. Here we go. The answer is B. Okay, so this is one of the major differences between prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells don't have any membrane-bound organelles. Eukaryotic cells tend to have lots of membrane-bound organelles. And those organelles are things that you are going to learn about in class this week. Okay, that's really it. I hope you enjoyed this presentation on cells, and we look forward to covering more topics with you in the future.